somehow I got to organize this footage into what I'm doing and what I'm not doing and what I encounter you doing. This has nothing to do with what I'm doing.
Do you want to?
Come on, as well.
Well, anyway, it's almost done.
What is it, man?
It's an Atari coin door out of a Superman. It's hammer tone black. Polished all the rusty metal.
Crap.
He didn't want it on his new cabinet.
Yeah. Okay, I see the return spring still needed on the reject or whatever. You got to put the coin mechs in it still, right?
Yeah, they're here.
Oh, you're working on that.
Other than that, coin door lock and then
I think you spent less than 5 minutes on that.
Glass VDs because they're rusty. Wash these because they probably don't work. They're rusty. Another half hour. I have 4 hours in it. Let's go. Well, let me get my coffee.
Okay.
I got to get this done for this guy. Look at this thing, man.
What is it?
This is not Megatouch. Take a look around in this thing. It's one of the ones I got from Steve. It's brand new, man. It was never anywhere. I mean, I want to change the Game Time I.O. board. And I don't like these aluminum heatsink fans. I want this Merit replacement because they said they run too hot, so they came out with these. And they suggest these for everything. They're copper. And they dissipate heat better than that aluminum thing. Heat is the enemy of these. Anyway, that's nice. Look how clean that. I didn't even touch it, except to clean the housing.
Yeah, well.
That's brand new, man.
And you built it out of a pile of parts.
Yeah, I did. I put the marquee on, you know.
Okay.
Because I took the Game Time one off.
Mm.
Yeah, it's brand new, man.
Sweet.
It never was in here. So I pulled these out of storage because I'm going to have to rob a board out of one. Until I order one for our trap.
All right, well, none of that is important, right? What's important is that we both...
Dead dishwasher.
Listen, no, that's not important either. Here's what's important, I'm going to tell you. You got to drop everything.
Hey,
two guys.
Charge him tax.
Two guys have to drop everything and run to go get a Mars God of War. We're going to go play storage God of War, right?
Oh,
we got to drop everything to go get a Mars God of War out of a storage facility because... somebody found us somehow and insists that I come get this thing.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, then, I won't say anything.
Like, this is, of all the things I want to do, I want to drop everything and go look at a Mars God of War in a storage facility.
I'm just going to be the dung truck.
I'm on the phone arguing with the guy over who's got more shit in storage that they need to get rid of.
I'm not going to say anything. I'm just going to be the dung truck driver. Because if I say anything, we'll get thrown out of it. Where is this?
I don't know. Nebraska. This ends this segment. Drop everything, Ray. Let's go.
I got a corn college drill.
Let's go there, too.
Room storage.
Hey, you know what else we got to do, Ray? While we're running around doing what we don't want to do? Let's go get that whodunit.
Oh, yeah.
Let's go get the whodunit. So there we can just, you know, we can stack Sanford and Sons strikes again. What did you see of the pin we were picking up? Was it what I'd feared, or was it something better than that?
About the same. It's about the, it was the same.
Train wreck, disaster, piece of shit, garbage, total flop, $50 auction piece.
Is hacksawing the leg bolt off qualified?
You hacksawed the leg bolt off.
Well, we couldn't get it off. What did you go up through? The busted up vent in the bottom?
I did. And
the vent went there.
So our good friend Joe is 2 for 2 at buying pins from the National Pinball Museum. Piece of shit 1 and piece of shit 2. Total piece of shit. garbage.
No wonder that place went out of business, and whoever owned it, they didn't maintain anything.
I wouldn't have walked across the street for that.
From what I could see, I don't think any of their stuff even took a coin to play, or took a card in this case.
So Joe, I'm sorry you paid us to go get that, because it's a piece of shit.
And if you ask me, that person or persons that damaged or wrecked 200 or however many machines it was, coin doors, to take it, make it take that card thing.
Yeah. Well, their problems are only started at the coin door, Ray. They're a disaster from top to bottom. That thing is dirty, broken, busted up. It couldn't be any more fucked up.
Them people, whoever ran that, no wonder they went out of business. They had no place being in business.
So I don't know what's going to happen with the whodunit back there.
The two things I've seen are terrible.
Disaster. Okay. That's not even. I don't even think that's interesting.
You should see this Morphe's thing, though. It's a nice auction house.
Okay, yeah, I hear it's a nice auction house full of junk.
Well, no, there's some high-end stuff.
Oh, high-end stuff, unless it's a pinball machine.
They were coerced in getting mixed up with this museum places stuff, though, and it is junk.
If this one's as bad as the last one we saw.
Dude, you don't have to park in the grass, right? Okay.
Drop everything. Let's go.
Let me get my coffee, and I gotta come back. I gotta finish that and finish the Megan.
Finish that.
I got a call in Collegeville.
Good luck with all that. Talk to the Rocky customer this morning.
Talk to the hand.
Yeah, talk to the hand.
Talk to the hand.
Yeah, remember that?
I don't. What is it? I know who it is, but I don't know what it is.
Yeah, I think that was in the T2 movie, the second one. Yeah, I think it was. You'd have to watch it.
Well, I'll tell you what I do have to watch is this footage again.
What is that?
Okay, folks. That would be the right decision, too, Ray. That would be.
Time's short, man. I'm old. You guys know how to get up. I'll shortcut through all that.
Okay. Throw it off. You don't even bother to throw it out.
No, just abandon it. Won't.
Storage wars.
Yeah, I am going.
Goodbye to all that
it is happening
stuff.
There. Yeah. Good luck with all of it. That TV show is...
For real.
That is more real than most reality shows.
Yeah, well, the problem is that the stuff is real, but the players are not.
Well, yeah, no, they have to add some drama to the thing, but... You know, that's a real problem. People, look at all these storage. They're almost like banks.
Yeah, they're full
of
shit.
They're building these damn things all over the place. And I'll tell you what, that is a way to make money.
If you own
one or two of them facilities, man, you got money. You got an instant big income. And you can even make money off of people's abandoned stuff with auctions. I mean,
sure.
It's just a no-lose thing, man. It's cool.
We blew it.
Yeah, we should have.
We do this.
Yeah, storage units, man.
How about being a moving company?
You buy a piece of land somewhere out of the way, just do that.
I want to see how many machines you can name that have been moved or prepped for shipping, but generally moved since our grand opening in the past 2 weeks.
That's the low end of things, man. Nobody wants to pay for it.
Curious. Well, I know, but I'm curious. I want to know how many machines you can name. That you've moved or prepped for moving in the past 2 weeks.
It comes along with a piece, except for the guys that buy machines and then hire a company to transport it out of state. But moving it local or transporting it to somebody's place after it's done, it's hardly chargeable, but it should be.
I just want to know how many. I want to hear them.
I don't know, 6, 8.
2 weeks.
I lost count.
Here, I'll start.
We
prepped the Rocky last night. Tore it down, prepped it, wrapped it up, gone. I'm just going to say one thing come to mind. Simpsons Pinball Party.
Right.
Gone.
Right.
Spooks. Okay, Spooks, gone. Both delivered to Delaware.
Right.
Two different locations.
Yeah.
Oh, how about a pair of, what are those things?
Rush the Rocks.
A pair of sit-down drivers from whatever decade.
1997
Atari drivers, a pair of them, loaded from two separate locations, One was your garage, and the other was the showroom.
Yeah,
it was on
I
display there.
That. Recon.
And they were delivered to where?
Parksburg.
Okay, well that's local.
Yeah.
Relatively. But wait, there's more. A Megatouch, the Megatouch Ion Evo, right?
Yeah.
Bucks County. Okay, that was relatively late.
Jameson.
Local.
No, that's only 40 miles away.
Okay, not necessarily a real big piece, but it was a piece out. He's out.
Yeah. Potential for more. I sold the Playboy of.
Well, the Playboy got moved. The taxi got. Joe's taxi got moved again.
Staged for work. We're gonna finish it.
Yeah. I thought I was on vacation. So, well, I was, because you did all that.
I wanted to get it. Well, it all led into each other. The one customer was Lindley's.
And all that stuff.
We moved. All right. I don't even want to get into that. We moved five pieces there.
All right. Here, I thought we just sat on chat forums all day and pushed buttons.
I'll be back. I'll be back.
Talk to the hand.
Say, I'll be back.
Ray, we'll talk to you all day.
Okay.
And I'm hungry. I want to get lunch.
I might be interested in that.
All right.
Ray may be interested in that for somebody else.
For my new garage.
Okay. We're having a... If you see something here... Well, never mind. If you see this car over here that you want, contact me and I'll contact you.
Very good. That'd be
Ray, tell us what that is, or you can, or whatever.
Yeah, but... It's a 65.
You're going to be on TV if you stand in the frame.
Yeah, we don't want to do that.
Okay, so then
it's a 65 Sprite Austin Healey.
65, right? Talk about 1965.
Yeah, good year for cars.
You were there.
Yeah, good year for cars.
That's pretty neat.
It's gorgeous. People refer to this as a project. Most of it is done.
Know that feeling. Did you know we restore pinball machines as part of what we do for a living?
No, I had no clue.
It's the same work.
Yeah,
it just doesn't have gas, tire.
I don't know. It's a little smaller. I prefer your guys.
Yeah. well, yeah, I guess you can't.
You wind up getting that many more.
I guess you can't pick this up and carry it around. Yeah. Okay.
I'm for friends of mine. I'm a technician by trade. And, yep.
Ray. You know, we got to correct my attitude, because I was driving over here feeling some sort of way about even considering bringing another pinball machine home, because it's the last thing we would ever want is another pinball machine.
Okay.
But that being said, I'm pretty happy, Ray. It looks like it's nice. I don't know. We'll plug it in and find out if it works later, but I'm happy. The guy said it was nice. Let me tell you, everybody that calls me, everybody tells me how nice their pinball machine is. Ray? How nice is the pinball machine 90% of the time? Oh my God. Well, we'll get pictures of this later. Looks pretty decent.
Glad to see somebody get use out of it. I'll show you a picture of my car.
Ray,
I drag raced for 20 years.
You spent more money, Ray. What'd you buy?
I bought the safety clean thing.
Don't you already have one of those?
Yeah, I do. I want one for my other car.
You want more?
Well, I have one in each garage.
You want to show them pictures of your car?
Yeah.
What kind of car?
Can you find it?
It's a 69 Plymouth.
It's gone. I'll follow you.
Yeah.
A Plymouth Fury?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Dodge.
No.
New. Straight six then.
No.
Four. Comes my...
It's a four cylinder.
I don't have
the Plymouth is a four cylinder.
You don't have it.
No, it's in my folder.
Well, that ruins this piece of footage.
Yeah, it does.
Bleh.
Substantiating, I enjoyed that.
Why can't talk about that, right?
No, I can talk about anything I want. It's America.
Oh my God, imagine that. Well,
you get what you deserve.
I didn't record it, and we don't need to identify what that was, because we don't need to. But we could have,
no,
we wanted to, but we don't need
no.
to. But rate that pick.
Nice.
It was a nice pick,
yeah.
Even for just the story you just heard.
Yeah, it's just nice, and I like that little clean tank thing I got. Yeah, neat. Yeah, nice guy.
Yeah. Anything you want to say about the pinball machine, your first, other than...
That one?
Yeah.
It's neat.
That's right.
It looks all right. It looks better than the one we had that one time. Where did we get that from?
I don't know. Howard.
Yeah, Howard.
Ugh. Wonder how he's doing. Okay. That's the end.
Have it done.
That's the end of this edition of GRC Pickers.
Yeah.
That was
GRC,
a pick, Ray.
Yeah, it was.
Mm.
Yes, we did that.
Okay, let's go eat.
Wouldn't that be a party?
Tech tips. What are your thoughts on that, Ray?
I have to pick a subject, man.
What are you doing today?
I'm going to do a job in a field, man.
Field job. Okay, you're going to show up. There's going to be 500 hours of work, or maybe 1,000.
Well, we'll divide it up. It'll go quick.
And we're going to get done whatever we can get done in the amount of time that we have before we have to come home.
We're going to West Pittston, Mike.
Oddly enough, I've never been there, I don't think.
Maybe you haven't, though. Well, it's a treat for you today.
Woo!
It's a treat, West Pittston, man.
Pinball Star Amusements.
Oh, my, there's an urgent message.
Okay, what do you think you're doing today? An overview, a pre-overview of what you did today.
What I did?
Yeah.
I guess we're going to put that Superman together.
Okay.
That won't take a lot, really.
Uh-huh.
I took it apart. Just put the play field back in, coin door back on. Assemble the head to the back cabinet. There's not a lot to it, I don't think.
Okay.
The other ones may have more involved, you know.
Uh-oh, phone.
It's Bill Lilly.
No, he can wait. I wouldn't make him wait too long, though, because...
The other one might be more involved, the Champion Baseball.
Okay.
The Williams... What is it? He has...
10 strike, 10 pins?
Is it 10 pins or 10 strike?
Whichever it is.
One or the other. That might be the easier one of them two, but those are at his house, along with a few repairs. So, I don't know, we'll just spend a few hours and see what we can do and make a difference.
Thing you printed out for me this morning and showed me what earlier.
Oh, that dude from Australia, yeah.
What did he have to say in a nutshell?
He likes the videos and he likes the commentary on the videos. He is also retired or about to retire office equipment technician in Australia.
Imagine that.
Yeah, imagine that.
What was his name? I want to say hi to him.
Kim.
Kim O. Kim O.
Yeah.
Newcastle, Australia.
Yeah, neat.
Okay.
I got out the email the other day. I sent him back a reply. I told him what I used to do, how I got into this.
Has anybody emailed you? Has anybody emailed you complaining about me yet? Really? You're not lying to me, are you?
No.
Has anybody said you ought to fire that guy? I think a few people have come to realize that, well, the race show goes on with or without me, but y'all don't get to see it without me. Because without me, it don't get recorded or produced.
I'm not into it. No.
You are not going to do that.
No.
I guess we are, you know, Ray, I gladly accept any volunteers that want to come chase you around with a camera. I wouldn't hurt my feelings at all. And they can do the video editing too. They can do all that.
I don't know of anybody else in this hobby industry that does what you do.
Why would they?
Well, I'm just saying, I don't know anybody. None of them do. The closest one that does this would be Todd, I guess. And he does it, but other than that, I don't know anybody.
Yeah, well, I'm offended that you say that what I do is anything similar to what he does.
Well, he films things.
Okay.
And commentary, Mike. It's not the same quality now.
Okay, thank you. Or it's got this sticker on it.
Yeah.
The local curse. And of course, once it has this sticker on here, you can...
Nice.
I missed. Get rid of that twat.
But it is the same type of thing.
Yeah, it's the same market. Well, not even there.
I mean, he's done TV things. I guess he's associated with a friend of his that does TV, but... He's always been in the video thing to tie this into video. You know?
Yeah.
Yeah. But, no, it's not the same thing in a lot of ways. It's what you do is more newer and innovative. What he's doing is so just old.
Somebody said avant-garde. I had to look it up, right? That was a review.
Yeah.
Cutting edge. Yeah. New shit.
That's what that means.
Out with the old shit.
Nice.
Front line stuff.
Yeah.
Although it looks all the same to me, Ray.
Yeah. Sure, like today. It's a gray day.
It really is a gray day.
Well, we got 45 minutes to go here.
Yeah. Figured I'd ride along with you and try to help somehow.
Yeah, we can put some of these together. It would go twice as quick.
It's a hard day for somebody your age to get up early, drive 3 hours to get there, work 10 hours, drive 3 hours to get home. Are you kidding me?
Yeah, that's a lot of work for anybody, let alone somebody that's coming up on 60. You gotta have a mindset to have the energy level up.
Yeah, I know you don't.
Because I worked last night till almost midnight.
You do it because we have to. We got bills to pay, and when we have bills to pay, we hit the streets and do the work required to collect the money to pay the bills.
Yes.
That's what we do. We pay our bills.
In a timely manner.
We don't bounce checks. We get it done. So, do we want to run this run? I mean, we like Joe, and we've talked, you know, he supports us and all that happy horse shit. This is a little bit above and beyond what a standard person would do for work, right?
Yes, it is. Yeah, it is.
And as many times as I filmed that tunnel back there, you've been up here 5 times that many times. It's no easy go. It's sure as hell ain't easy money. It ain't easy money, right?
Travel's hard. There's a lot of risks driving around today. Equipment breakage, accidents, construction. Yeah, it's not easy. The further you travel, the worse it is. And that has nothing to do with what you charge to do it.
No.
It doesn't make that any easier. The extra money of work.
Well, No, it doesn't. The travel fee is really a wash, if anything. And it's a wash minus your labor hours. This is gimme time. We charge basically what it's going to cost to run the truck back and forth.
Yeah, 100.
And the 6 hours is on the house of driving. It just is. Now, of course, he's going to hand us, well, if we work 10 hours, we'll charge him 12, because we'll charge him 8 for you and 4 for me, and he'll pay full rate, and it'll be a nice service bill for us. But like you said recently, you know, we earn our what we charge. That's the way I look at it, right? And you know, frankly, if Joe didn't want to pay for this, which I still think is just ludicrous, the amount of work he has, and the past two pieces we picked up for him are like, why? It doesn't make any sense. This whole business doesn't make any sense, Ray. Why? Well, maybe it makes sense to somebody. It doesn't make sense to me. The value of this. But if not him, the stack of work back home in the storage facility at your house, at my house, and at the showroom, and probably 6 other places that I can't think of right now, is more than enough. More than enough, right? So that being said, I think you should fire the guy with the camera, because you don't need advertising. This is just a waste of your time. Cut the expenses.
I'm gonna eat my sandwich.
Sell the camera.
Sell the camera. I'm gonna eat my sandwich.
Okay, we're on break. We don't need to watch you eat. What a trigger. A trigger burger?
Trigger burger.
Ray's Tech Tips. What's in there, man?
It's an Atari from 1979.
You know where I was in 1979? Joe, where were you in 1979?
Superman.
Where was I?
I don't know.
12 years old. I was in a womb. I'm older than you.
What did they do the same and different back there, right? Because it looks a lot different.
Well, it's early electronics. You got your bridge rectifier power supply assembly up here.
Okay.
And they had large filter capacitors because their power supplies are probably dirty. They leak voltage, so they compensate with that.
That big cap.
Yeah, both of those.
About as big as a soda can.
Yeah, that big one's probably for lights, you know, keep them from pulsing back, you know.
Okay.
And then, of course, the MPU is there, and we have lithiums on there. Joe sent all these away to John's Jukes.
John's Jukes did these? Did the board set on this? No? Nobody did them?
Well,
Flippers, they were.
If his name's on there, he did, but I didn't send them. They
I thought you sent one board to him because it was broke.
No.
No? Somebody did, and that guy does nice work on these things. But both boards, this is your lamp driver board, and then display area here. Sort of similar in design, you know, they separate them and they have a joiner.
Okay. Well, this machine doesn't look too beat. I mean, the cabinet looks okay.
Okay, it's perfect.
Okay. Struck a note.
The coin door.
It's Felix, and we don't have Felix anymore.
The coin door. The coin door looks all right. Right?
Just all right. Read it, yeah. Stop dogging on all these great pinball technicians.
Oh, man. This thing's pretty cool, Joe. I like it. I like it.
It's actually a very fun game. It's very addicting. It's simple rule set.
Yeah,
big white play field.
Yeah, I read the rule set. There it is.
It's an addicting game. It's actually one of the first games I ever got. I bought it at the Allentown show probably in 2003, and it was one of the, you know, probably the third or fourth game I ever bought, and I've never sold it.
Gotta wipe the glass off.
That's very cool. You've had that game. This is one of your first games.
Yeah.
I had to rehear what you said, because you have so many games that you know, it just doesn't that doesn't sink in.
Yeah, this is one I never got rid of.
Neat. Well, Felix did it justice, I think. It looks spectacular. It's really, really nice. and Ray put this together here today. Here, that was only slightly challenging, not so bad.
I like the cool whites; they make the colors nice. Mm-hmm.
Okay, Ray, let's fix something out else. That's all y'all get for Superman. We're moving on. I don't care about your coin door, Ray. I don't care how long it took you to do that coin door. I really don't.
I like it. It's nice. Fits the rest.
It's like the grill on a car.
It is.
First thing you see.
The front end of the machines is right, that's where it's at. And how many coin doors look like garbage?
Well, yeah, nobody wants to take the time. Once you get into a coin door, it's pretty elaborate.
How many hours did you spend on that, Ray?
Probably 10. The WPCs are nice because you just put a new one on there available.
Yeah.
These, where are you going to get it?
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah. That's pretty fancy.
You know, and it's not just outside. You got to do inside. Now, this will take coin, too. This is all set for whatever you want to do with it.
Okay. Nice work as always, Ray. You do so much. You do so much nice work, Ray, that it really is getting really boring.
It is.
Start doing some crap work so I have something to talk about.
Yeah. Bash it.
Day.
Are we back through this hole in the...
We're going through the hole in the wall again.
Yeah.
Wrap it up. Tell everybody what we accomplished today, what we didn't.
We put together 2 million games that were out to paint, so we reassembled them. Atari Superman and a Williams 10 Strike. Tested them. That was pretty much... It's a lot resembling a game like that.
Well, what went into we'll talk about the Atari. What had to be done there?
Side rails, coin door, all the wiring had to be reattached, to the...
Rerouted.
Yeah, and the little wire holders.
Flipper buttons.
Yeah, a lot of cosmetics.
Glass trim.
Yeah. Back box.
Oh, yeah.
Just every little thing, probably 100 screws, and nails.
Looked at a BSD, found it had a bad power driver board in it.
Yeah, we were evaluating that.
Put an interconnect board back in a Pinball Magic.
Yep.
That you repaired.
Yeah, and then we reassembled them 2 games and tested them. Yeah, it took what it is now. 10 after 9. We got out there around 12 noon, I guess.
Yeah. That's long enough. So, if you've got nothing else to say, Ray, I'm going to...
What is that? 10 hours?
9.
9 hours?
9 hour day. We cut it a little short because we had... No, because we're still making a delivery. We're still working.
Until you drive home, you're still working.
Yeah, we're dropping off a pin somewhere else. That's all I got, Ray. I want to thank Joe at Pinball Star as always for supporting us and making it possible for us to come up there and do that with his incredible, it's beyond incredible collection of stuff.
Yeah, it's very nice. Well paid attention to assembled there.
Truly amazing. And nice guy, nice to work with. We love Joe.
He's my insurance guy too.
Call Joe for your insurance needs and or WAS, MMR, Hobbit, Spooky.
Yeah. Spooky, yeah.
All that stuff.
He does that from a hobby standpoint. The insurance that he does is mostly commercial, but he pays attention to all the things that you need.
He got us straightened out.
And I have way lopsided policy on almost everything. So I can find a personalized service in our area.
So that was our day in a nutshell, Ray. It was more than enough. I'm tired.
that's my X-File.
Yeah, well.
I'm 50 this year, Joe.
What?
That's 20 years ago.
Hit with the times, right?
So now, all right, now I'm supposed to watch this Breaking Bad. Is that it?
I don't know. I don't watch it, so
what
I don't
know. What the hell is that?
I don't know. I think the guy,
No.
All right. Somebody's had to correct you because I've never seen it. I'm just going off what I think
I've
heard.
Series, I guess.
It's a series. It's an AMC series.
AMC.
Like Walking Dead and that. Yeah. I think the guy is like a... he's like a high school teacher or something, and he's like a science or he's like a chemistry teacher or something. And I think he's diagnosed with terminal something. He's only got a short time to live, which makes me wonder how there can be 15 seasons of Breaking Bad.
Well, the doctor was wrong.
So, since he's kind of on his way out, he decides he's going to use his chemistry skills to make drugs. He makes drugs, and it's about how he distributes these. You know, he makes a distribution ring for these drugs so that he can support his family as he's going out.
Wow, that's all controversial.
Yeah. So, and I may be totally 1,000% wrong on that because I've never seen the show. That's my guess.
All right. Well. I'm not done with the X-Files yet. I'm only on season 2 episodes.
X-Files. But what you should be able to watch the cheap because they're total ancient reruns.
Oh, it's Netflix I got.
Okay.
Yeah, so I just go and watch it on that. That's a subscription, but yeah, you can watch all kinds of neat stuff on there besides TV shows. You know, they got movies. I like that.
That's really boring, Ray. It made me yawn.
Red fish?
No fish.
I got red cheese fish.
I'm going to turn the camera off and take a nap. That's all for this episode of Ray's Tech Tips. We are going to be back with more and more. Ray, I'm carrying this camera around again. I don't know if you noticed. I'm getting back to it. Got some nice comments today about people excited about us being back. We're excited about being back. I think. And, yeah. So that's it. Signing off. We appreciate you watching and subscribing and commenting and supporting us however it is that you want to. And look forward to seeing you again soon. Bye, everybody.
Hi. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you haven't already subscribed, what are you waiting for? Want to know what's coming next? Go like us on Facebook right now. You can keep up to date with all of us here at the shop and what we've been up to.